Thank you for tuning in to the Ballot Scanner Review. At this station, you have the Ballot Scanner, the Black Ballot Collection Box, the I Voted stickers, the Pink Provisional Bag, bins for clean items, and bins for dirty items. Once a voter has finished making their ballot selections on either the touchscreen or paper ballot, they're going to this final station where they will submit their ballot, either in the Pink Provisional Bag or feed it directly into the ballot scanner. Though only voters with an unfolded ballot and a secrecy sleeve are allowed to feed their ballot into the black ballot box. If the voter doesn't have a secrecy sleeve but an envelope with a folded ballot, they will then need to seal their ballot inside the envelope, either the pink provisional envelope or the yellow conditional voter envelope, and drop it into the pink provisional ballot bag. Now, all this makes the ballot scanner position an extremely important role. Whoever is stationed here must be very diligent and make sure that ballots are casted correctly. So again, it all comes down to the secrecy sleeves and envelopes. If the voter has neither, then ask them to go back to their voting booth and get the secrecy sleeve or the corresponding envelope. If a voter comes towards the ballot scanner station holding an envelope, direct them to that pink provisional bag. Ask the voter to double-check that the envelope is sealed, filled out completely, and it's extremely important that they sign and date it. Make sure that the voter takes their receipt stub with a tracking number, which is located on the envelope flap, so that they can easily keep track of their ballot and/or registration status. If a voter comes to the ballot scanner with a secrecy sleeve, direct them to cast their ballot directly into the ballot scanner, just like it's pictured here. The ballot can be cast in any orientation. Each ballot card just needs to be guided in straight and one at a time to avoid jamming. When inserting a ballot card, the LCD screen will display "Ballot successfully cast." This message, along with an audible chime, will let the voter know that their ballot was accepted and dropped into the ballot box. They are now ready to insert their next ballot card. If the voter doesn't wait for that message and then proceeds to put in their next ballot card, the scanner may jam and the LCD screen will display jam error. Remember, ballot cards automatically cast when they are inserted, unless the voter, prior to inserting, requests to review their choices on the scanner's LCD screen, which the lead can activate ballot review. Use the I button security key to go to the ballot review settings in the main menu. Enable the standard review and enable the electronic review. Now the voter can review their choices on the LCD screen. If they are satisfied with their selections, they must hit the cast button. They can insert their next ballot card and review their choices on that card as well. Make sure to keep a respectful distance between you and the voter so that their selections are private. The voter must hit cast or return for each card they insert under ballot review. If the voter chooses to return a ballot card and wants to change their selections, they'll have to get that ballot card spoiled and reprinted. When the voter has finished casting their ballot, you must disable the ballot review. After the voter casts their ballot, double-check they drop their Sharpie, stylus, voter card, and secrecy sleeve in the respective dirty trays. Offer them an I Voted sticker from the table and point out the trash receptacle in case they want to throw away any gloves or any other PPE items. We hope this video has been helpful. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, please email training@rov.secgov.org. If you have any questions during election hours, then call the ROV at 408-299-POLL.